Hello everyone, Marine here for Learn Fun. Welcome back. Today the mouse family is back again. It's been a while and I missed those cuties. We joined them to make a love potion. I picked my images from a bunch of stem sets, so let's check the supplies. For the stem sets, push here for the heart, science of love for the test tubes, Wild for you for the mouse, Fortune Teller Tabby for the bottom of the crystal ball, Keep Swimming for the aquarium, Crazy Antics for the mice, Unicorn Picnic for the sprinkling thing, A Creature Was Stirring for two mice and a spoon, Merry Mice for the stool, You're Just My Type for a small heart, Dance with Dan for the open book, pile of books and tiny heart, and Thanks a Latte for the heart. Next, for the die sets, Let's Toast Pool Tab, Scripty Love, Picket Fence for the strip die, and Large Stitch Rectangle Stackables for the biggest die. So here we have all my cute images. I stamped everything using jet black ink and used the coordinating dies to cut them all. And as always, I used my beloved alcohol markers to color everything. The black ones are spectrum noir markers and the white ones are graphite brush markers. Next step was to create the background, so I cut a 5.5 by 4.25 inches stitched panel and I entirely covered it with Bansuga distress ink. Next, I taped the brick stencil to my panel using washi tape at the back and used Pictrasberry distress ink to create a super bright wall for my scene. And to make sure that the brick design would look nice, I didn't make big circle motions, I just kind of rubbed and pounced my blending tool on the stencil. Next, I did what I always do with a distressing background, I added some texture. First, water droplets that I dried using a paper towel. Next, I smooshed my Pictrasberry ink pad onto my glass surface. I added water to the ink and then used a small brush to splatter a bunch of tiny droplets on the paper. And finally, I wanted to add a lighter touch to that background, so I mixed some white acrylic paint with water and used my small brush again to create splatters on the wall. Next, I moved on to the interactive part of my card. I created a simple counter using wood grain cardstock that I temporarily taped at the bottom, and I marked the middle of my panel at the top. I used my T-ruler to mark the middle a little bit lower and took the notch die from Let's Toast pull tab, placed it right up against the top edge of my panel, and sent the panel to my die-cut machine. Next, I used my T-ruler again to mark the middle of my panel above the counter. And before moving on to the next interactive element, I assembled the cauldron. I fussy cut the bottom of the crystal ball, used a black marker to cover the white edge of the image, and then I stuck it at the bottom of the aquarium. So next, I placed the cauldron where I wanted it to be in my scene and marked the top of it. And I taped the slot die on the vertical line right below the pencil mark and sent the panel to my die cutting machine again. Off screen, I cut the pull tab element out of clear acetate and folded the score lines. I put the tabs at the back of my brick wall through the slot. Here you can see the tabs. I flipped the panel over and attached the sleeve to make sure that the pull tab goes up and down straight. So I folded the score lines and applied double-sided tape on the middle part. Placed the element between the acetate and the paper. And then I applied double-sided tape on the smaller end and folded the sleeve to keep the pull tab in place. Next, I trimmed off the excess of acetate at the top and stuck the remaining piece of brick wall at the top of my acetate pull tab. Next, I realized that the tabs were too big, so I just cut each tab in half. This way, the acetate won't be peeking out from behind the heart. I placed the counter at the bottom of the panel and applied one glue dot at the top of each tab. Here's a close-up look to see the glue dots. I placed the cauldron in a way that it was covering the slot and then attached the heart on the acetate tabs. And next I realized something else. The acetate wouldn't stay flat. It was blocked by the counter. So I stuck a small piece of acetate at the bottom of the tab to make it longer. And the problem was fixed. I applied foam tape on each side of the pull tab, making sure not to touch it, and then I stuck the counter. I used more foam tape at the back of my panel and attached my brick panel to a ballet slipper card base. And then I assemble the images on my panel, starting with the cauldron by applying a foam square on each side of the tab. Next, I attach the remaining images, and to give the illusion of taller piles of books, I cut the white border on one image. I cover the white edge using a black marker, and then stuck the images using foam squares. Once everything was attached, I moved on to my sentiment. I wanted it to be very bold, so I started by coloring a piece of paper using Candied Apple Oxide ink. And I sent it to my die-cut machine with the Scripty Love die as well as the Arrow Handle die from Let's Toast Pull Tab. I cut the word love a second time out of white foam and stuck my red love word on top. And I attached my dimensional sentiment right in the middle of my panel, above the big heart. And I also glued the arrow at the top of the pull tab. Off screen, I used a white gel pen to add highlights on the images. And finally, I applied glossy accents on the word love to make it super shiny. And this is the final result. The love potion is ready. Who wants some? I hope you like this card and that you were happy to see the mouse family again. Thank you so much for watching and see you next time. Bye!